So legal experts this week have been talking about the fact that, of course, with the New York fraud trial, Donald Trump's businesses in New York could be completely dissolved. Now, as of this recording, we do not yet have that ruling. Now, by the time you hear this, perhaps we do. But as of right this second, we do not have that ruling. So legal experts have been talking about the fact that they don't agree with the dissolution of the Trump Organization as a whole, because they think that that would be a little too just vengeful, right? That's not necessarily something you should do according to the law. You're only going to do that because you hate Trump. And these are actual legal experts, not left or right, but they don't think it's a good idea. But it's what one legal expert pointed out that made me realize that it doesn't matter if Trump's businesses are allowed to continue. They're still dead on arrival. Let me read you this. This is from Columbia University law professor Eric Talley. And this is what he said about Trump's businesses possibly being dissolved. He said, quote, "This is basically a death penalty for a business. Is he getting his just desserts because of the fraud or because people don't like him?" Now, of course, he's talking about, is this just vengefulness or is this because of the letter of the law? But he brings up a good point. People don't like him. People do not like Donald Trump. And that's certainly no reason to punish him. You can't be punished just because you're not likable. But that statement made me realize something more important. People don't like him. Now, what did we see happen when Donald Trump became president? His businesses across the globe took a financial hit. Except, of course, for the money coming in from foreign dignitaries in foreign countries, right? And conservatives, when they could, they'd hold their events at his properties, put money in his pocket. He was, of course, going to play golf at his own properties, charging the Secret Service for golf carts and meals and everything else. And so he made money, but the general public didn't use his properties as much. Because, again, people don't like him. So if Donald Trump suffers this massive financial blow, hundreds of millions of dollars, plus the $88 million that he now owes E. Jean Carroll, he's going to have to sell some properties to get that money liquid so he can pay the fees. So he's going to sell some properties. He's going to be left with a couple places, probably, maybe. But then what happens? What happens if all he has is Mar-a-Lago and Bedminster? You think the average Trump supporter, those people that show up at his rallies, do you think those people have enough money on hand to pay the hundreds of thousands of dollars per year to be members at those places? They don't. So that's why I say that even if New York does not destroy Trump's businesses, then they're going to suffer an even slower, more painful death because the people who do have money to go to those places don't want to go to those places. The people who would do anything to get in those places can't afford it. Trump has alienated the wealthy people in this country to a degree where there's not enough of them left that like him that will continue paying. And in terms of getting loans from banks to restart his real estate empire, well, a fraud conviction, well, fraud judgment against you is basically going to kill that opportunity too. So he has cut off basically all of his lifelines to more money, because the only people that love him in this country anymore are the people who he can't stand to be around because they don't have the money to join his little clubs. Ring of Fire is just a few subscribers short of hitting that 1 million subscriber milestone. So if you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and do so and stay up to date with all of the latest from Ring of Fire.